Discussion of Eisenmenger syndrome and complications. Initial paper by Victor Eisenmenger was published in 1897 and was named Congenital Defects of Ventricular Septum. The first description was of a 30-year-old man who had features of Eisenmenger syndrome in 1894, who succumbed to massive hemoptysis later. Eisenmenger syndrome can be considered as the final common pathway for all significant left-to-right shunts in which unrestricted pulmonary blood flow leads to obstructive changes in the pulmonary vascular tree. This leads to progressive pulmonary hypertension, which is initially reactive and reversible, but later on obliterative and irreversible. The pulmonary vascular changes include medial hypertrophy and intimal proliferation. As the pulmonary vascular disease progresses, irreversible changes like plexiform lesions and necrotizing arthritis develop. When the pulmonary vascular resistance exceeds the systemic vascular resistance, reversal of shunt occurs, causing systemic desaturation and cyanosis. Generally, this process occurs only with pulmonary to systemic flow ratio, QP by QS, of more than 2:1. Eisenmenger syndrome with ventricular septal defect is known as Eisenmenger complex. This will be associated with exertional dyspnea and impaired exercise tolerance in most persons. Palpitations can occur in more than half of the patients, of which 40% can have atrial flutter or fibrillation, while 1/10 can have ventricular tachycardia. Clinical signs of pulmonary hypertension are remarkable in Eisenmenger syndrome and include a left parasternal right ventricular heave, palpable second heart sound, pulmonary component, and sometimes right-sided S3. Pulmonary ejection click, vascular non-phasic, and a soft ejection systolic murmur can be heard due to the dilated pulmonary trunk. High-pitched decrescendo diastolic murmur of pulmonary regurgitation, Graham-Steele murmur, can also be heard in many. Peripheral edema can be noted with onset of right heart failure, which is usually quite late in the natural history of Eisenmenger syndrome. X-ray chest in atrial septal defect with pulmonary hypertension. Upturned right ventricular type of apex is seen, along with hugely dilated pulmonary artery. End-on view of pulmonary artery branch is also seen. Due to chronic hypoxia as a result of systemic desaturation, erythropoietin levels are elevated and causes polycythemia in Eisenmenger syndrome. Excessive polycythemia can cause hyperviscosity syndrome. Symptomatic cases need phlebotomy with care to avoid microcytosis due to iron deficiency, which is the strongest predictor of cerebrovascular events. Microcytosis also causes decompensated erythrocytosis, as they are less deformable and produce renal ischemia, being unable to negotiate the renal microvasculature. Renal ischemia in turn increases erythropoietin levels, further worsening polycythemia. Platelet function abnormalities and coagulopathy are also common in Eisenmenger syndrome. Thrombotic complications like stroke can occur, especially in the setting of dehydration or following contrast angiography. Brain abscesses are also potentially serious complications to be looked for, especially when they present with neurological deficit. Cerebral microembolism and airway hemorrhages can occur. Airway hemorrhages have to be thought of specially when moving from lower to a higher altitude, as during air travel or while ascending a mountain. Even though it is very important to rule out correctable causes in a patient with suspected Eisenmenger syndrome, it is equally important to avoid aggressive testing, as patients can die during cardiovascular procedures. Adequate hydration prior and during any contrast angiography is essential to prevent stroke. Oxygen therapy may have a role in reducing the levels of pulmonary hypertension. In a study of 1,098 patients with Eisenmenger syndrome, 405 were on advanced therapy for pulmonary arterial hypertension at baseline. Most of these patients were on endothelin receptor antagonist, phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitor, or prostacyclin analog. only about 10% of the patients were on dual therapy. As patients were recommended advanced therapy during the study period, by the end of the study, 690 patients were on advanced therapy for pulmonary hypertension. There were 278 deaths in the study period, of which 51 were in pre-tricuspid defects, 130 in post-tricuspid defects, and 97 in complex cases. Median follow-up period of the study was 3.1 years. Definitive therapy of Eisenmenger syndrome can be in the form of heart-lung transplantation if feasible.